entrance and guests present, women's guild representatives here, church institution representatives, university vice chancellors who have come join us, ministers from other churches, invited guests, staff of the Presbyterian University of East Africa, alumni, parents, and students, all protocols observed. I now call upon the moderator of Kikuyu Presbytery, Reverend John Owero Mati, to lead us in devotion. Reverend John Owero Mati.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Yes, I am Mati. As you have heard, I'm happy to be here this morning to share with us the word of God. And before we hear the word of God, I'm going to read from the book of Haggai, chapter 1. Haggai, chapter 1. And I'll read from verse 1. Thank you. And the Bible says, on August 29 of the second year of King Darius' reign, the Lord gave a message through the prophet Haggai, to Zerubbabel's son of Shealtiel, governor of Judah, and to Joshua, son of Jehozadak, the high priest. This is what the Lord Almighty says. The people are saying, the time has not yet come to rebuild the Lord's house. So the Lord sent this message to the prophet Haggai. Why are you living in luxurious houses? Of my house rises into ruins. And here comes the pass where we are getting a theme. And that is, this is what the Lord Almighty says. Consider how things are going for you. You have planted much, but harvested little. You have food to eat, but not enough to fill you up. You have wine to drink, but not enough to satisfy your thirst. You have clothing to wear, but not enough to keep you warm. Your wages disappear as though you are putting them in pockets filled with holes. This is what the Lord Almighty says. Consider how things are going for you. And as I said, Our theme this morning is that we should give careful thoughts to our ways. And this was a call from our brother Haggai, telling people to retreat, telling people to look back, telling people to suck their hearts. And this book is believed to be written by Prophet Haggai, and the purpose of writing this book was to challenge the people to complete the temple, that is the house of God. And as much as they complete the temple, they were as well supposed to build up their lives. They were also supposed to have their relationship with God mended. And the key people that Haggai is referring to, number one, is Zerubbabel. And Zerubbabel was a political leader, meaning that even the political life of the people was not good. The other person that Haggai is talking to is Joshua. And Joshua was a priest, meaning he was a church leader. Meaning, even in the church, things are not going on well. Haggai is also talking to Zechariah, who was a prophet. There is no one today who is telling people what will happen tomorrow if they don't make their ways. So Haggai is talking to Zechariah and telling them to tell people that they need to retreat. They need to give careful thoughts to their ways. And this morning, God is talking to us through our brother Haggai that we should give careful thoughts to our ways, meaning we are not going as we are supposed to be going. We are not behaving, we are not working as we are supposed to be working, and as servants of the Most High God, we should give careful thoughts to our ways. So, this was a call to repentance. And it is what God is telling us this morning, that we should also repent before God. All of us are short of His glory. Our politics are sick. Our education institutions are sick. Our churches are sick. It is like everywhere people are sick. But when we humble ourselves before God and repent, He is able to heal our hearts, number one. He is able to heal our institutions. He is able to heal even our country. So let us all humble ourselves before God in repentance. May God bless us as we give careful thoughts to our ways. Let us pray. Almighty God, in Jesus' name, we humble ourselves before thy presence, acknowledging that we are not worth to stand before thy presence. And because you have spoken to us and have told us to repent, that is why this morning we are repenting all our sins. Whatever you have seen us transgressed against you, O God, have mercy upon our lives. We thank you because of this gathering this morning. How we call upon your Holy Spirit to be together with us. How we call upon you to guide us, O God. Give us a good beginning. And as we continue with your presence together with us, we know at the end of it all, glory and honor shall be back to you. Be with us, bless us, O God, for this is our prayer of faith. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you. May God bless you.
Thank you very much. In singing the hymn that is on page 48 of your program, slowly in the morning. Band, please. Please stand. Please stand, please. shall not have the purity of entertainment, and I invite our choir to give us our first tune, our choir piece, Your Honor.
Thank you.
Please let them, let us give the choir another round of applause, please. Choir master and the pianist, Mr. Park and Kim, thank you very much. We shall now hear spoken word from Emmanuel Kevati. Please come forward and give us the spoken word.
The chief guest, Director of Criminal Investigations, Mr. George Kenoti, the moderator of the 23rd General Assembly of the Presbyterian Church, Reverend Deb Motai, the Chancellor, Dr. Julius Wantai Mwamba, the Vice Chancellor, Professor John Mungania, distinguished guests, PUEA family, and the world. Education is the most powerful weapon that we can use to change the world. It is an experience that makes one noble, widens one's thoughts, takes away ignorance, and it eliminates poverty and illiteracy. The scripture tells us that those sow their sins with tears shall reap with joy, carrying their sheaves to them. And as it is said, hard work really pays. It is because of their commitment, resilience, and education that we are here today to celebrate them as they graduate from this great institution, a fully chartered university. We call it PUEA, the Ava of Africa. Congratulations to you, class of 2020, a class of strong, talented, beautiful, smart, ambitious young men and women who have given out your best to achieve your dreams. I know it took you persistence and commitment to achieve this great milestone. Being at PUEA has been a great opportunity for you, where you've acquired knowledge and skills that has been handed down to you by our amazing lecturers. And this would be of importance to your lives and to the entire globe. Statistics show that those who have left these grounds have earned a palpable impact in the world. Those who have gone ahead of us from PUEA have disrupted cultures, transformed global politics, revolutionized economies, and I know you too will go ahead and do equally significant things, if not more. And so, class of 2020, you graduate from PUEA. You're so much worth in and out of yourself. And so, I implore you in the great philosophy of our university, always do things all decently and in order, and be humble. Humility being the willingness to see all humanity as equal and accepting to serve within this rare blend of courage, integrity, honesty, accountability, and above all, the fear of God. More than ever, our generation needs individuals who have received holistic transformative education that will change the world. As our theme states, education for resilience in a dynamic world, and you are equal to the task. It is my hope, class of 2020, that it shall be said of you that you embodied these virtues in the days to come. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Emmanuel, for the spoken word. Finally, we have a short poem, as recited to us by Paul Kibbe. The poet, Paul Kibbe, please. It's your time. Is Paul Kibbe here? A short poem by Paul Kibbe.
My name is Paul Kibbe, and I have a poem, PUEA University After the Charter. After the charter, PUEA is now the Harvard of Africa. PUEA is the new PAR, Innovation Center of Research and Technology. PUEA is the good way to all communities, to all Kenyans, to East Africa, to all grounds of people, and to the world at large. Since 2008, many academic heroes have emerged with their thumbs high and their necks raised up higher for being a product of PUEA. The green wanderers standing and serene vegetation in PUEA gives many the passion to strive. PUEA teaches the best and leaves the rest. The place to be is PUEA. The global place with dignity is PUEA. The place of achievement is PUEA. The place the first Presbyterian missionary, Thomas Watson, settled. The place our first president, the late Mzee Jomo Kenyatta, studied. The news of PUEA is reversible. PUEA is the cradle of excellence. Long live PUEA. God bless PUEA. Shalom.
May I ask the representative of the graduates who are going to graduate here today, Musumba Margaret Isisa, please come forward and say something on behalf of the graduates who are going to get their qualifications today. Please welcome.
are alienations, jubilation, and raw optimism. In my remote areas and village of Budalani, Busia County, that I am very humble that my villagers are looking at this milestone as a testimony of resilience, as a success amidst all the obstacles and barriers. Needless to say, history brings us here through a long winding journey that can only be defined by believers as a miracle. Indeed, it is a miracle. It is a miracle for those of us who not only witnessed others dropping out of school, but also the never-ending pressure upon our beloved community. But thank God, it is now past. Our university, the university, was underrated last year. We have endured. We have remained resilient. Many of us never imagined the beauty of this world. But here we are. It is our time. It is our time to take those powers, to read and to do all that appertains to the award that we are being granted to do. It is our time. Our time to remind the grandchild in those remote areas, in those remote corners of this great country, that winning is never the preserve of the few. It is for the resilient. It is for those who dare to dream and to follow their dream. That success is not for a few, but it is for a few who choose it. It is not for extraordinary persons, but it is for the ordinary persons who do the extraordinary things. On behalf of my colleague graduates, I hereby extend our gratitude and appreciation to all of us who gave us this opportunity, to our parents, to our beloved lecturers. Sorry for that. On behalf of my colleague graduates, I hereby extend our sincere gratitude and appreciation to all of you who gave us this opportunity, to our parents, our beloved lecturers, and the government of Kenya. Indeed, we are truly empowered, we are fired, and we are ready to go out there and find the new paths. Education is not the preparation for life. Education is life itself, just what joined you. You have armed us with the resilience needed to face the dynamic world. We promise never to let you down. To my colleague graduates, creativity and innovative approaches to life should always define us. As we go out there, let not be part of the problem, but form the part of the solutions. And to the youth of this country, you have the opportunity to craft your future, so do not waste it. Always remember the words of the most famous son of this continent, Kofi Annan. Knowledge is power. Information is liberating. Education is the premise of progress in every society, in every individual, and I dare say, in every family. As we go out there, let's believe in ourselves. The first and the foremost thing that defines an individual is the belief in yourself. Trust your potential. Even if you are asked to give away, if you don't know, say yes. You will learn along the way. May God bless you. May God bless Kenya. May God bless the Presbyterian University of East Africa, our alma mater. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Margaret, for that message on behalf of our graduates. Chief Guest, the Director General of the Directorate of Criminal Investigation, Mr. George Kenoti, the moderator of the 23rd General Assembly of the Presbyterian Church of East Africa, Right Reverend Patrick Thego Mutahi, Chancellor Sir, Presbyterian University of East Africa, the Reverend Dr. Julius Wantai Mamba. I now have the pleasure of inviting our Vice Chancellor, Professor John Mungania, who will make his remarks, and thereafter invite our Chairman of the Council to address us.
good will wishes to this occasion, and also those of us who are present here. I just want to say, as much as many people are watching out there, as much as celebrating, I am a witness that Christian who believes, even those who are going before us, they are still watching and they are with us here. And at this juncture, I want us to remember in a big way, those of us who have labored so much, even to see the success of this day as the first graduation when you are a chaka. I'm reminded that, of course, we have lost quite a number of people who have been instrumental to a day like today. For example, the late first moderator, the very Reverend Dr. Johnny Gatto. This one was our founding chairman of the board. And he went to be the Lord. And I hear he left his message, which will be told by the family sometimes at the university. We have the late Reverend Patrick, the guy we lost the other day, supporting the labor in the council and everything in the BOT. We have the late Dr. Robert Karanja, We have the late Reverend Michael Mundia, who was a member of our council, and the day he went to be with the Lord, that was the day he was doing the answers, to receive the challenge. We have the late Professor Bachanga. This one was the chairman of Akuru County. All of these have been with the Lord, and I'm sure wherever they are watching with us. Because as a person believes, they are not there, but they have been separated from us, and now they are watching this great day of the first graduation when you are chartered university. And so, allow me, sir, Chancellor, to ask the head of Department of Theology, the Reverend Dr. Micho, to come and lead us in observing moment of silence for these great warriors during this great day, our first day when we are chapter. Reverend Dr. Micho Tafadhali.
Just keep on the other one.
May I request that we stand? Many times we remember those that have gone before us, arising from what they did, their deeds, their actions, their life. Let's take just a minute to remember as they were mentioned. Father in heaven, those that were mentioned in our presence, we stand to remember them. They lived with us, we served with them, we heard them, their contributions, their dedication,
their commitment to the life and the work of our institution. Today, we remember their families, those that are left behind, that Lord, you may watch over them, provide from your riches in glory to their needs, Father. We pray that what we learned from them, we may practice in our lives. Prayer of faith through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you.
Many of our people have given their responses to us and we have received them. Very important guests who have really responded to our call. Today's PUEA 11th graduation ceremony. It was unfortunate due to coronavirus pandemic. We could not have this day last year, 2020. And so we are graduating that cohort. We are graduating that class of 2020. And the parents are so excited. The students are so excited. I know, wherever they are, watching our Runinga here, through Kirk TV, they are so excited that we have now started graduating them, giving them power to do, to read, and do all that about this, the degrees, the promotion they are going to get. So, Mr. San Sebastian, with me, I have Madam M.S. Cindy Cantler, our friend from USA, is one of our serious partners. And she sends her best wishes, and she says, I cannot travel due to COVID-19 restrictions, but I'm with you in the spirit. And I'm sure she is watching, even in the US. We have the CEO of Mission for Inverted Education, Professor Mwendan Tara Angwe, who received an invitation very well, according to the reports that we have. We have their chairman. I think Commission loves us so much because they know now we are Chatham University. We have their chairman of Q, Professor Nyaigoti Kichacha, who sends his best wishes. And he says, unfortunately, I've lost my father. I will not be able to attend the graduation. But congratulations to the graduates. We have Bishop Nomura,
Mudo Akanjita Gasantai.
Who is the president?
Kogo Dita Mwere Akwa Mwantiere Akwa.
And also the Methodist African Church President, who came here in person to say, I'm here with you, but because of his commitment.
Okay.
He sent his representative, Bishop
George
Malomba, who is here with us. We have Professor Mary Lomo. This is the Vice Chancellor, Kirenyaga University, who sent our best wishes. Professor Constantine Matoke Nyamboga, the VC, Lukenya University. She really wished to come, but she said I watched from there. And so I understand she's watching. We have Professor Samuel Gudu, VC Robo University, who has seen us a successful graduation. I say I'm watching. We have Professor Philip Mayo, VC, University of Eastern Barracon. And he says he also be watching wherever he is from Papu. We have the Vice Chancellor, Kenyatta University, who has sent our best wishes. We have Professor Simiu Barasa, Vice Chancellor, Taveta University, Taita Taveta University. We have the VC, St. Paul's University, who also is wishing us well during this day. We have Dr. Kim Kiruhi. This is Vice Chancellor, International Leadership University. And he says, I watch wherever I am. We have Dr. Vincent Ogutu, Vice Chancellor Designate, Strathmore University. We have Sister Patronila Imeh-Imo. This is Deputy Principal, Administration and Finance, Ekima University College. She accepts our invitation and since she's watching out there. We have very reverend professors living in Bongwa. We see Kavalok University. This is what we call PUEA. In fact, this is our sister or brother. Because we are PUEA, they are PUEA. And they send their best wishes through the Vice Chancellor, the very reverend professor Stephen Bogwa. We have Dr. Charles Moli, Moli Children's Home. They say with the children, they are watching out there. I'm sure Kirk TV, you can see whether our people are watching, but I know they are watching us. We have Mrs. Grace Gesuhi. This is the secretary or legal officer of our own church, Presbyterian Foundation. She also sent her best wishes, and I'm sure she will then be here with us. We have Catherine Monene from Chogoli University, from Chogoli Hospital, who is the administrator. These and many others, when Chancellor Sir, have wished as well during this day. They are eager to see it happen. Meanwhile, we have those present with us, and they confirmed their attendance in person. Because there are people who say to come in person, others we say the worst version. So we have these two teams, great teams watching this graduation as we proceed. We have the very reverend Dr. Jessica Mount, who is our DOT chairman, is present with us and he has sent this confirmation. Your Professor Francis Bichaga, who is our council chairman, here with us. We have Reverend John Mwati, Kikuyu Presbyterian moderator. The fellow gave us the word this morning. We appreciate that. He's here with us. We have Honorable Esther Durango, DOT member. She's here with us. We have Professor Njenga Munene.